let's get this straight right off the bat. There are different levels of sim racing enthusiasts. Some are into gaming, some are into realism. Some are box racers, and some are PC racers. And in the case of cockpits, some have very tight budgets, and some have a bit more money to spend. The VRC 1000 cockpit from Carriage Works is an absolutely amazing piece of work. It's so good looking that you're going to find yourself wanting to just sit and look at it, like an exquisite car or a piece of artwork. Okay, I don't know anything about that one, but cars and bikes, hey, yes sir, I know. The paint quality is top-notch with powder-coated finish that's really nice. All the tubing is big, 1¾-inch steel laser cut for precise fitment. And to the tubular frame is attached the pedal plate, wheel plate, and the floor, all made of flat steel. Now, the attention to the small details of this construction is incredible, with small screws and the silver plates for the floor and the nose section. And the entire cockpit sits just off of the floor on 6 padded aluminum feet. And there are wheels on the rear of the cockpit and a handle on the front for moving it around. But as beautiful as this rig is to look at, it is to drive. The adjustability of the cockpit is a little different to do than most, but very good in its end result. Like any good cockpit, there are 3 main areas of adjustment: the seat, the wheel plate, and the pedals. The wheel deck has great angle adjustment as well as a slide for moving it toward or away from the driver. And the entire wheel deck can also be adjusted up and down to get the wheel to the proper height for you. The pedals can be adjusted for distance from the driver, but do lack any angle adjustment. And finally, the seat is mounted on a slider for adjustment and ease of entry and exit in case of a fire or a bathroom call. The shifter mount is stationary and is not adjustable. So the VRC is a beautiful rig with lots of adjustments, but we also need one more very important item before we can pronounce judgment. Is it solid? There are a lot of nice cockpits that fall short in their rock-solid test, but rest assured the VRC 1000 is indeed solid. The only discernible movement that we had any issue with is the shifter, and that was really very minor. The cockpit comes with a very nice metal box where you can slip your PS3 or Xbox in, and there's a monitor stand that is truly a work of art. Now, after all this praise, let's get to our problems with the rig. 1, I wish the shifter was adjustable. Fortunately, it is in an almost perfect location, so it's really not that big of a problem. 2, there's no place to mount a butt kicker. Now, if that seems like a small complaint, then you've obviously never raced with one. 3, I think that the wheels are a great idea, but it seems like the handle should be on the back and the wheels on the front, since every time I went to move it around, I needed to aim it up against something, not aim it away from something. And 4, the VRC is designed for box racers with a mount and monitor stand, but it lacks the extras that a PC racer needs, like a place to mount a keyboard tray or a button box. And finally, 5, which is the big one. For me, the seat that comes with this thing is absolutely the worst seat that I've ever sat in. The back cushion pushes you out of the seat rather than snuggling you in. Now, I hunted around the internet, and I only found one other review of this rig, and they never mentioned the seat problem. For me, though, it gave me such a backache that I could only race for 5 minutes and I was done. Now, fortunately, you can get the VRC without a seat and use that money towards something you prefer. And that's exactly why you won't see me racing in this rig. So the bottom line, this is a fantastic cockpit, but also an expensive one at $950 for the full setup and $750 for the chassis alone without the seat. Now, for this kind of money, I feel that it should be ready to go for the PC racer, whom I think are more typically the higher-end buyers. And of course, it should at least include a real racing seat as an option, along with the keyboard tray and button box holder. So, stay tuned as we give you the footage of this thing in action, along with the modifications I made to make this thing perhaps the best cockpit I've ever sat in.